Good afternoon, students of class 7. Welcome to history class. We are reading chapter 10, The Far East in the Middle Ages, and our lesson for today is 10.6, The Yuan Period, The Mongols, Kublai Khan. Now, in the last class, we read about the Song Period, which was the major period or major dynasty who brought together or unified China after the fall of Tang Dynasty. Now, towards the close of the Song rule, that is in the 13th century, many cruel people invaded China from the north and the west. Of these invaders, the most powerful were the Mongols. So, after the fall of Song Dynasty, when their rule came to an end, many forces from north and from the west, they were invading or attacking China. Of these powerful forces, Mongols were the most powerful. In spite of the strong resistance offered by the Song rulers, they ultimately failed to stem the tide of the Mongol invaders. Ultimately, Kublai Khan, the great Mongol leader, became the undisputed ruler of China and founded the famous Yuan Dynasty, which ruled this place from 1279 AD to 1368 AD. Now, the Mongols were wild nomads who lived in the barren deserts and rugged mountains of East Central Asia. Thus, they became a formidable and painstaking people because they lived in so harsh conditions that they were conditioned to these difficulties. So naturally, it was very difficult for the normal people to defend them. At first, they were divided into number of clans and tribes. A Mongol chieftain of the name of Temujin united various clans and tribes. So these people, these Mongols, were wild nomads who used to roam about in the deserts, and they lived in clans and tribes. This Mongol chieftain named Temujin, he united these clans into one group or one tribe. Temujin is known in history as Genghis Khan. The term Genghis Khan means the son of God and total hero. Under his leadership, the Mongol conquered one kingdom after another and built a vast empire. Kublai Khan was the grandson of Genghis Khan, and he was the greatest of all Mongol leaders. It was he who overthrew the Song Dynasty of China. Under his initiative, the city of Peking, which is present-day Beijing, was planned and constructed. That is why Mongols called Peking Khanbalik, meaning city of the Khan. So during the rule of Kublai Khan, a great conqueror that he was, the Mongol Empire extended over a vast stretch of land. As you can see in this picture, this is the Mongol Empire under Kublai Khan, this orange mark portion. So from this itself, you can guess that how great a conqueror he was. Now we will read about Kublai Khan in detail, but that we will do in the next class. For today, it was all. You will read this section from your book and see whether you have any difficulty understanding it or not. If you find any difficulty, send your query in the given mail address. Thank you.